A while back, I got a comment from a viewer that said that I was using HTTP client incorrectly to call the Finance API. So if we look at our Finance API services, such as the stock price service, we create a new HTTP client for each request, and then we dispose of the client when we're done via this using statement. But constantly creating and disposing HTTP clients is actually a poor practice, and the Microsoft docs even say this. I'm going to link a really great article below that explains why it's bad to constantly create and dispose HTTP clients, but the main idea is that every time you create an HTTP client, it creates a new socket. But when you dispose the HTTP client, it doesn't immediately release the socket. So if you constantly create and dispose HTTP clients in a short amount of time, eventually you're going to exhaust the number of sockets that are available, and you're going to get socket exceptions, and you're not going to be able to make requests. So instead, our application should instantiate a single HTTP client instance for the entire lifetime of the application and never dispose it until you close out of the application. So in our HTTP client factory, we could just store this single HTTP client in a static variable, but having a static HTTP client can cause stale DNS problems. And we'd also have to manually dispose the HTTP client when the application closes. So instead, what we are going to do is register an HTTP client in our host services, and that will correctly manage the lifetime of the HTTP client and also ensure that only one HTTP client is used for the lifetime of the application. So to get started with that, what we are going to do is add a NuGet package that is going to let us add an HTTP client to our host services, and this is microsoft.extensions.http. And instead of version 5, we're going to use version 3.1.1 because we have not migrated to .NET 5 yet. So let's install that. So now that we have that package, we can use an extension method on our services to add HTTP client. And there's two approaches to this. You can have named HTTP clients or you can have typed HTTP clients. Now, we already have a specific financial modeling prep HTTP client type. So we're going to take the type approach and we will add that type here for the extension method. And there we go. But we can also, here we go, there's a constructor that where you can name the HTTP client if you want to take a named approach. So that also works with the typed approach. But anyways, there is another constructor here to configure the HTTP client. So we are going to use that action. And what we can do is set the base address here. So currently we actually set that in our HTTP client class. We can grab that and move that to our extension method. There we go. Clean that up here. And this class actually needs to change. So we're no longer going to inherit from HTTP client. Instead, we're going to take the HTTP client through the constructor, and we'll just call it client, and we're going to put that in a field up here. So let's generate that, and then update our getAsync method here to use the client. And now, this HTTP client is going to get injected into our finance HTTP client, and the injected HTTP client is going to be the single HTTP client that gets managed by our host services. And it'll also apply this configuration for us. And even if we added another HTTP client and had some other type, and then this some other HTTP client took an HTTP client in its constructor, it would have the same HTTP client that's in the financial modeling prep class. So overall, we ensure that there's only one HTTP client instantiated in our application, and its lifetime is all managed by the host. So now we need to update our services because these take the HTTP client factory, they create the client using the factory, and then dispose of it when it's done. Now we don't implement iDisposable anymore, and we don't want to dispose our HTTP client anyways, so we can get rid of these using statements in each of our services. That'll be the first step that we take. And now instead of using the HTTP client factory, we can just inject the actual HTTP client. So let's get rid of this factory and rename this. We'll just call it client. And we no longer have to use a factory. We already have it. So let's just update this. And there we go, much simpler. And let's do the same thing in the stock price service as well. Get rid of the using statement, get rid of the factory. We'll rename all of our variables and fields. And there we go, no more HTTP client factory. So we can go ahead and actually just delete it and remove that from our services. So now we're good to go. Let's go ahead and check this out, make sure everything still works. We get an exception because we cannot resolve the financial modeling prep HTTP client. and we cannot resolve service string. So that sounds like an issue, and the reason for that is because we register this HTTP client in the dependency injection container, but it takes this API key, which is just a string. And obviously we don't register a string with our services. So we really have two options here. The first option is we could inject the iConfiguration into our HTTP client and then grab the API key from that configuration, the same way that we do here with getValue. But I really don't want to do that because then we'd have to know the actual key to get that value from the configuration inside of the HTTP client, which is kind of weird. And then obviously we can't and shouldn't register a string in our services. So what I'm going to do is create a folder for models, and then I'll just have a class called Financial Modeling Prep API Key, and we'll make that public, and it'll just have one property on it, a string for the key. And we'll even make it read-only and generate a constructor for it so that it can only be set one time. And then we can use that constructor in our configure services. So we will add a singleton for a new financial modeling prep API key, import that and pass in the API key. And now since we've wrapped this finance API key in a class, we can inject this class into the HTTP client instead of just the raw string. And then we can grab the value of the key in the constructor and set it as our API key. And now we're good to go. So let's try this out. We'll log in, and it has grabbed our data. So our HTTP client is working. And look at that, in our debug logs, we actually get logs from our HTTP client. So that's interesting, I like that. But most importantly, we're now managing one single HTTP client for the lifetime of our application, and we don't risk exhausting socket resources, which could be unlikely for a small desktop application, but better to be safe. So hopefully you guys can use this in your own applications. If you have any questions, criticisms, or concerns, be sure to leave them below in the comments section. But other than that, stay tuned for more. Thank you.